What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Noob. I want to come to you this week with a manga that gives a bit of a question for you. If your dad is a hero, and your mom is a spirit, what does that make you? Well, the answer is it makes you reincarnated. Yes, I'm going to be talking about an isekai that really doesn't delve into the isekai fact, but is still one hell of a read. The title of this manga is called Dad is a Hero, Mom is a Spirit, I'm a Reincarnator. Now imagine this, a kingdom plagued with battles, and a hero arises, accompanied by the Queen of Spirits, who lends him his power. He goes into battle, defeats the demons, defeats all the enemies, and yet he is injured. And the queen, taking pity on this human, takes him to the spirit world to heal him. Kind of sounds like a really good story, doesn't it? Well, unfortunately, that's not the story we're going to be talking about. That is actually what happened 10 years prior to the story that we are going to talk about. The hero and the spirit queen did leave, and 10 years have passed. The kingdom has been saved, but everyone has been waiting for this hero to return. Unbeknownst to them, on this special day, the hero has returned incognito with a little someone by his side. Now, who might this little someone be by his side? Well, that is our main character. Her name is Ellen, and she is a reincarnated person. Now, they don't tell you a lot about her. They actually maybe only mention her reincarnation once or twice in the story. You basically know she was a scientist and she died really young. That's about it. We don't know how she died. We didn't know anything else. We don't even know her real name. But that doesn't matter. This little girl is the daughter of Set Hero and the Spirit Queen. What does that make, Ellen? Well, that makes her a half-spirit, and it also gives her powers equal, if not greater, to the spirits of the world that she's from. And thanks to her knowledge of elements as of being a scientist, she actually uses those to create elements in this world. And I'm talking stuff like take carbon and turning into diamonds, or, you know, taking medicines out of nothing and creating something that can clear plagues. She has these overwhelming power that she likes to use to help people. Well, lo and behold, while her and her father are out there trying to check out the town, he's, you know, introducing the human world, he is spotted by his bodyguard from 10 years ago and is chased down by this bodyguard. Your hero is named Ravel, and he is the eldest son of the Vancrift family. He was the hero of the kingdom and someone who has been waited for a very long time. But it doesn't really matter because he doesn't want to stay because, one, he has become half a spirit, spending 10 years in the spirit realm, and two, he is one of these over-loving parent types when it comes to his daughter. I mean, he is always like, oh my gosh, she's so cute, I want to burn memories with her, blah, blah, blah. If she tells him that she's disgusted with him, he is down in the dumps. He is one of those kind of parents, you know, uberly adorable, yet sometimes a little cringy. Unfortunately for Ravel, it seems he's not going to be able to go back to the spirit world as he intended because the bodyguard tells him that shit's happening at home and he's got to go back and take it. But before he does, he decides that he needs to do something very important. He goes to a church, calls his wife from the spirit world, and makes sure that everyone knows that this is my wife and now we are officially married in the human world. Now, Steve, from this point on, shit kind of goes a little weird for him because Ravel just wants to go back home with Ellen and be happy with his wife, who, by the way, is the Queen of Spirits, if I did not tell you. Her name is Lady Origin. She's the Queen of Spirits. She runs everything. She is Ellen's mom, and she is uberly jealous of any woman who gets near her husband. I mean, dumb jealous. Like, when one girl kind of brushes up against her husband, she starts asking Lena, which would be better, if I set the world on fire or if I sank it all in the ocean? I mean, she's that kind of jealous. It's like, bitch, you need to calm down. But enough about the family. See, Ravel gets dragged back into this, even though he didn't want to. Now, you might be wondering, why doesn't he want to come back to the human world? Well, it's simple. He does not like the kingdom. And the spirits don't like the royalty for certain reasons. So he wants to protect his daughter because he knows the instant she comes out into public knowledge, shit's gonna hit the fan, and unfortunately, shit does hit the fan. Now, there are a lot of things that happen in this story, and they take some quite interesting turns. Ravel goes back and he helps his brother get rid of his wife, who is this money-spending whore who is uberly fat and just like, she for some reason will drop the brother husband because she wants to marry Ravel, and she even lies about stuff and, you know, shit like that happens. And then, because of all this, the person that Ravel does not want to meet unfortunately finds out that he has a daughter. The person he really hates the most is the prince and later future king of this kingdom, Revazel. And this guy is the epitome of jackass, in my opinion. He is so, I'm great and I'm doing the best thing for the nation no matter what, no matter what schemes and evil things I do. He's one of those fuckers. Like, seriously, he knows for a fact the spirits do not like the royalty, but he is damn determined to figure out how to get the spirits working for them again. When he finds out that Ravel has a daughter, he does everything to meet up with this girl. He goes to any schemes, any way he can, between, you know, trying to fake that the that fat wife, that the daughter of hers was actually Ravel's. There's a point where he even purposely interferes with rumors and stuff to make the family look bad and says, if you want me to clear him up, I just need to meet your daughter. When he does meet the daughter, he is kind of creepy because she outsmarts him all the way, and he instantly says, I want you to be my daughter, I want you to marry one of my sons. He just does not understand no is no. He's one of these kind of jackass royalties, and he's just The interesting thing about the reason why the spirits do not like the royalty, and this one I kind of find very interesting. See, the spirits do not like the royalty because there is a curse upon the royalty that affects the spirits very bad. Now, you would think this curse is something that is actually meant to harm the spirits, but no. This curse was because of what the royalty, several centuries ago, did to the spirits. See, way back in the day, one of the previous kings, he was dead set to get the power of the queen to help him protect his land. But the spirits, you know, they take time to get the queen, and he wasn't having that. So he was literally grabbing lower grade spirits and torturing and killing them in front of the spirit door to try to get the spirit queen to come out so he could basically force a contract on her. Little did this king know that there are a lot more powerful spirits, and you fucked with the wrong family. So they come out and a curse is put on them between the spirits and the dead spirits, basically making it to where the spirits cannot interact with the royal family. And it is quite interesting. Now, I have liked this manga so far. It's kind of short right now. There's only, I think, about 30 chapters out right now. But so far, each chapter I have not been disappointed with. It doesn't matter if it has to do with them having to deal with the scheming prince, or if it has to do with just dealing with new family members. The maids, the brother of the hero, the grandmother who just dotes on Ellen, the butler who asks her to call him grandpa. All these characters that she interacts with are so perfect. And even the ones that are scheming and jerks and kind of, they're perfect for what they're needed for. And so far, I have loved every chapter of this. Now, like I said, this is an isekai that really, really doesn't talk about it itself as an isekai. It almost feels more like a fantasy with just an itty bitty 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 sprinkle of isekai. But I think for those people who don't like isekais, this would probably be a very good isekai to still get them in. And, you know, granted, there's some isekai facts where, you know, she has knowledge, so she shares it. Like, one of the things that she does is teaches them about a clean hospital and something called triage. She actually introduces that, which helps the kingdom. But she doesn't go overly isekai like most of them, where she's overpowered and, you know, rescues and save everybody. It is an actual good small isekai for those who don't like isekais. Now, what about you folks? Do you think this is the kind of story that you would like? The half-spirit little girl who helps out the world in her own way? Or are you more of the traditional overpowered isekai character? Let me know in the comments below. Anyways, folks, I'm the Noob. Thank you for joining me, and I will catch y'all next time. See ya!